Guys, you've probably heard by now from the news and my Instagram and all that that my boat sunk last Saturday. We'd been competing in a fishing competition 30 kilometers offshore, so I think it was 17.1 nautical miles straight out of my local marina, and I'd anchored up a couple times. The anchor wasn't holding, so I decided I'm gonna hold the boat on the mark with the motor. And unfortunately, we had one slightly bigger wave than all the others come over the transom of the boat and swamp the deck. After the first wave, we noticed that the back of the boat had probably 150, 200 litres of water in there. So I turned the bilge pump on and it was all fine in the beginning. The water was pumping out, no worries. And I looked back and I noticed that the bilge pump had almost stopped working. The water was now only trickling out of the side exit for the bilge pump, and that's pretty much when I knew we're going to have a problem, because that wave that came over in the beginning brought in quite a bit of water, which meant the back of the boat was now sagging, and that meant that all the other waves that weren't huge, you know, just your average size chop, were now coming over the back and into the boat. And maybe 30 seconds after the first big wave, the boat was like really sagging, and we're bailing out the water. Three times the amount we're bailing out is coming back in, and that's when I knew we're gonna have a serious problem. So we grabbed the safety gear, my crew put his life jacket on. I didn't have time. I was just holding on to mine because I was in the middle of making a mayday call on the radio to the local sea rescue. So I picked up the radio handpiece and I just said, "Turox Marine Rescue, Turox Marine Rescue, copy. Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is Bravo Quebec 060. Bravo Quebec 060. We are taking on water and our boat is sinking. Mayday, mayday, mayday. Our boat is sinking. Bravo Quebec 060. Bravo Quebec 060. And because I was logged on with Sea Rescue, they had a rough idea of where I was, but I still read out the coordinates off the GPS in front of me twice. They read them back to me and they were correct. And by now, the boat, the motor had died and the boat was starting to go down fast. So I just said on the radio, "The boat's gone." And I jumped out. My crew wasn't so lucky. The boat went down so fast from that point that he got sucked into the cabin and the esky floated up, blocking the hatch, meaning he couldn't get out. Me floating around on the surface now, I'm booting and pulling and pushing and everything to this esky through the hatch, trying to move it out the way so he can get through, and it just wasn't enough. He could not squeeze through. It was getting to the point where I thought, there's no chance. And then all of a sudden, we got lucky and he squeezed out. So now we're floating with the boat, we're like, "Oh my God, oh my God," and he was holding the bag that had the flares and EPIRB, and unfortunately he had to drop it as the boat went, because he was, you know, main focus was getting himself out and surviving. So now we've only got our life jackets, we're hoping that the coordinates were correct. They did read it back to me and it was correct, but when you're floating in the water like we were, you're just hoping that everything got through and they know where you are and they're on their way. Lucky, there was a bulk carrier anchored 2 to 3 kilometres away from us, and there was a like service boat. It was an ex-water police boat, like quite a big boat, I don't know, maybe 60 foot or something. We'd seen it go past where we were fishing, I don't know, maybe 45 minutes before this incident happened, and they were actually on their way back as we were floating in the water. So they obviously, they said that they got our mayday call passed on to them, and they knew that we were in the water close to their location. And lucky enough, the life jackets we were wearing had whistles on them. We managed to whistle really, really loud, and eventually they heard us, turned around and came came and picked us up. We'd been floating in the water for between 45 minutes and an hour before that boat picked us up, and maybe another 5 to 10 minutes later, sea rescue from two different places, and then like Department of Transport boats rocked up as well. So there was four Department of Transport and rescue boats, and also the boat that picked us up. So there was five boats there, which was lucky for us. The helicopter was also on its way there, but we got picked up before it got there. Yeah, we're just very, very lucky that the Mayday call got through and we were found. I could have easily not been making this video right now and you wouldn't hear from me again. Unfortunately now, we are without a boat for a long time. Main thing is that we survived, but the boat was uninsured, and now we are about $20,000 down, which means it's going to take a while for us to get a new boat. Especially that now we want to get something big and beasty that hopefully this doesn't happen to. The boat we were on is a 20-foot half cabin, and it's pretty much designed for the river. Like, it's capable of going out to where we did, but it's not really designed for it, which contributed to the incident happening, having a load of the water transom. So hopefully within 10 months we'll have a new boat. That doesn't mean I won't be posting videos. I'll make as much content as possible, get it out to you when I can. It won't be as good or as frequent as it is now, but there will be stuff up every now and then. Yeah, just make sure when you go out on your boats, you have your safety gear within arm's reach so that if something happens, you can grab it as fast as you can and be ready. And make sure that if you can log on with the Sea Rescue, I know some people live in places where they don't have Sea Rescue, but if there is a local Sea Rescue, make sure you log on. Because we were logged on, Sea Rescue already had a rough idea of where we were. I told them we were going 30 k's out, and where this happened was 30 k's out, so they knew that was a general area where we were going. So yeah, make sure your safety gear is within arm's reach, log on, be aware of what's going on around you, don't go if it's too rough, and stay safe. I'll roll on now the Channel 9 segment from boat incident, and after that I'll play some clips from good trips we had on the boat. Thanks guys.
Good evening. Two young fishermen have survived a terrifying ocean ordeal, forced to tread water for an hour after their boat sank off Two Rocks. The teenage skipper and his mate were unable to reach the EPIRB and flares, only saved by a last minute Mayday call.
Stranded 30 kilometres out to sea.
You alright?
Two fishermen struggle to stay afloat. The skipper is just 14.
Hey, can you hold this for a sec while I set my life jacket off, please? Don't, make sure you don't drop it. I'm so sorry, man. I didn't think this was gonna happen.
The bow of the 20-foot boat is barely visible. Its EPIRB and flares stuck inside.
Have you got the bag? Oh, I dropped it.
And 5 minutes later, it goes under.
The boat's gone. Make sure you're not tangled in any ropes.
For the next hour, Floyd Bohannick and his 20-year-old mate tread water, hoping the Mayday signal they just managed to send means help is on the way.
Just stay with the boat, because there's heaps of bait and fish in the water.
Eventually, after drifting nearly 400 metres, they're spotted. Three men on a boat servicing a bulk carrier hearing their radio distress call.
Oh, there's a boat! Hey! They won't hear, just wave.
We could see someone standing up on the front of the boat looking around, and then kept blowing louder and louder with the whistles, and eventually they turned around and came for us.
First time I've fished two individuals out of the water without a vessel close by.
The pair had been fishing off Two Rocks about 11:30 yesterday morning when the boat started taking on water.
Thousands of people have been in the water here at Two Rocks yesterday as part of a fishing competition. But despite the masses, no one spotted the pair struggling in a 1.3 metre swell as their boat sunk 50 metres below.
Floyd Bohannock says his radio call saved their lives and wants others to learn from his ordeal.
What started as a small search area could have quickly turned into a very large one. Very lucky boys.
Mia Edgerton-Warburton, Nine News.
My heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now. And there goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hoping now. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I broke. Oh, 'cause I need you to see that you are the reason. There goes my head shaking.